the next stage of my travel, I was off to Nara, Kyoto, and Fukuoka. I decided on getting a Japan rail pass ahead of time for unlimited travel, as I would be using the Shinkansen bullet train and JR subways extensively on my trip, especially within these cities. I was planning to go to Suzuka to drive a few laps around the Suzuka International Racecourse, but a typhoon got in between my plans and the famous track.
Typhoon Malakas has made landfall in Japan. Maximum estimated sustained winds were about 185 kilometers an hour near the time of landfall.
I was lucky that typhoons didn't cause more issues with my trip, as one occurred just before my flight to Japan and also just after my flight back home. I woke up early to catch Shinkansen to Nara in the morning. Travel time was about 4 hours. I stayed near Deer Park during my visit there. I wanted to see the shrines, the deer that roam freely there, and the Mochi Master that my friend had talked about. There was always a crowd watching Mitsuo Nakatani and his staff at Nakatani Do pound delicious mochi for the masses over 24 years. Well, I'm all done packing here on day 5, ready to go over to Nara Station, heading over to Kyoto now. The next day I was off to stay with Atsuko and Yuji at their home in Kyoto. Atsuko was kind enough to pick me up at Isayama Station during the end of the typhoon, saving me.
Hi.
And taking me to their home in Otsu.
Hello.
Hey.
Welcome.
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa. Okay. Niku.
I can drive you to the station.
Oh, okay.
In the morning.
Atsuko, Yuji, Sawako, and Zen were all very nice to me during my stay there. The next morning, I was off to Fushimi Inari Shrine, famous for its infinite orange archways. So we're at Fushimi Inari right now. Let's go take a tour. I really should have done more research, as I had no idea how much of a hike visiting this shrine would be. After walking up a few hundred steps, I came across a "You Are Here" sign. Saw that I was only about a third of the way through and swore very loudly inside my head. Later on, I was fortunate enough to meet Ben Lee, who was traveling from Boston. Quarter of the way through, or?
Well, you know what the concierge told me? Don't go all the way up to the top.
Yeah.
He said just go halfway.
Then all the way back down. That'll be fun.
It's always easier.
I'm already dehydrated as it is.
Where are you from?
Toronto, Ontario.
Toronto? Benjamin.
Yeah. Tao.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. You're from?
Boston.
Boston, huh?
We continued through the rest of Fushimi Inari, walked around Kyoto, and we're on our way to Kyomizu Dera. Kyomizu, one of the most beautiful places I've ever seen, means clear or pure water. This is because of the waterfall that runs there. People who drink it are said to be granted wishing powers.
How's it compared to the first ones you went to?
This is much bigger.
Yeah?
This is also closer.
It was nice to meet Ben there while traveling. we parted ways at the end of Kyomizu. After traveling around all day, I was super dehydrated. I still had to make my way to a couch surfing event at Mangetsu no Hana Cafe, where I quickly began to drink all of their water.
We're all in this room?
Yeah.
Okay.
I met my friend Masaki for the first time, who was hosting the language and culture exchange there. Then it was time to head back to Otsu and call it a night.
Just backing up right now to head over to Fukuoka to meet up with Minoru and Mayuko's family and stay there for the weekend.
Yuji-san, with his family, drove me back to Ishiyama Station.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
You can come back anytime.
Thank you. Arigatou gozaimasu. Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa, I'm Mayuko.
Ah, thank you.
Thank you.
What is this? Camera.
This is a camera. This is my iPhone, a beautiful game.
Okay. Konnichiwa.
Soon after we met, I was on my way to see a Japanese baseball game. Being a Toronto Blue Jays fan, it was nice to see the team that Munenori Kawasaki once played with, the Fukuoka SoftBank Hawks. It amazed me how Japanese fans have non-stop energy. There was never a pause in the cheering, singing, and drumming for all 9 innings. The rival team, the Nippon Ham Fighters from Hokkaido, also had a fan cheering section there. I divided my attention between the fans there and the baseball game. I wish we had the beer service that Japan has. Vendors just carried mini kegs and poured out ice-cold draft beer. The 7th inning stretch had all of us blowing up balloons, singing the team song, and then... it was time to go home. The following day, I traveled around Fukuoka, taking in the festival's food and scenery. Here at Shingu Beach, certainly not dressed for the occasion. Hot as hell out here, taking the scenery. At night, on the advice of Minoru, I went to Dazaifu Tenmangu Shrine to see the Lantern Festival. Simply said, there was a performance from the shrine maidens and 1,000 candles lit at night to appease the god of learning. Packing up here after a great weekend here at Fukuoka, heading over to Tokyo again. One more time, a few more things off my checklist I need to tick off. On my last day in Fukuoka, Mayuko and Minoru took me to Canal City Hakata to have tempura lunch. It was my first time using a ticket vending machine to order food. It was a fantastic stay there, and it was now time to head back to Tokyo, for the last leg of my trip.